اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه محمد بن عبد الله عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد في الأولين، وصل على نبينا محمد في الآخرين، وصل على نبينا محمد في الملأ الأعلى يا أرحم الراحمين. Alhamdulillah, we're continuing with our daily tafsir, the tafsir of Al-Mu'awwidhatayn, the last two chapters of the Qur'an. And in them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent a great blessing to our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is our second session of surahs 113 and 114. And today, after we did the introduction the last time we met, we're going to speak about the virtue of Surah Al-Falaq, Surah An-Nas, these two beautiful last chapters. And I think one of the places to begin is a hadith that I mentioned to you in our introduction, which is the hadith of Uqba ibn Amir radiallahu anhu arda. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, when he would have a soft spot for someone, or when he felt someone was in need of something that was tailored for them, and there was a need that he saw in them, or there was something that was worthy, that they were worthy of receiving from him, he would يَخْتَصُّهُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. He would specify something in particular for them. Al-Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayhi, he records from Uqba ibn Amr that he said that the Prophet was walking with Uqba ibn Amir. And Uqba says, I was leading the Prophet, meaning I was walking a step or two in front of the Prophet ﷺ, showing him a path through the pathways of Mecca, or Medina, excuse me. And he said to me, Ya Uqba, ala tarkab, Uqba, will you not ride with me? You know, the Prophet's on his camel or on his on a beast of burden, and Uqba is leading him along the way. Prophet ﷺ says, will you not ride? And, you know, he says, yani, I was scared that if I was to say, yes, O Messenger of Allah, that would be something, strange. So the Prophet ﷺ got down from his camel, and Uqba ibn Amir got up. And this is a beautiful, beautiful kind of thing. Like, could you imagine the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He offers you a ride, and he offers you to take his place, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Uqba says, the only reason I took it isn't because I was tired, or I was honored that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I didn't want to disobey him, something he wished for me to do. And this shows you the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the Prophet adds the true love. And the true love in this life is not just simply doing acts of kindness to people, it's leading them to as-sirat al-mustaqim. So the Prophet ﷺ says, Ya Uqba, alu a'allimuka, O Uqba, should I not teach you suratayni min khayri suratayni qara'a bihima an-nas? Should I not teach you, O Uqba, two chapters of the Qur'an from the two best chapters that any human being has ever recited? And I said, Bala ya Rasulullah, of course, O Messenger of Allah, teach me. And the Prophet said, Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq, qul a'udhu bi rabbil nas. كيف رأيت يا عقيب. Then the Prophet, you know, makes a little bit of a change to his name. Instead of Uqba, he calls him عقيب, meaning my Uqba, the one I love to give this information to. He says, كيف رأيت يا عقيب اقرأ بهما كلما نمت وكلما قمت. O عقيب, O my dear Uqba, read these two verses whenever you wake up and whenever you're about to go to sleep. And this hadith is narrated by An-Nasa'i, Abu Dawood, and Imam Ahmad, rahmatullahi alayhim ajma'in. It's a famous hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. In another authentic hadith, in another narration of it, إِنَّ النَّاسْ لَمْ يَتَعَوَّذُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَيْنِ. Mankind have never asked Allah for protection in any better way than these two chapters. And then he said, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ عَلَيْهِ أَفْضَلُ الصَّلَاةِ وَأَتَمُ التَّسْلِيمِ. You also see that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, he mentions to Uqba that these two surahs were revealed to him on that night. It was revealed to him their importance on that night, and he wanted to share it with Uqba, رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. And in that narration, the Prophet ﷺ said, مَا سَأَلَ سَائِلْ بِمِثْلِهَا. No one has ever asked Allah with anything more powerful than them. Meaning asking Allah for His protection, for His assistance. وَلَا اسْتَعَاذَ مُسْتَعِيذٌ بِمِثْلِهَا. And no one has sought refuge with Allah with better than those two surahs. Another powerful statement of the Prophet ﷺ. Now don't think that this is just, you know, to Uqba ibn Amir and so on. You're going to hear narrations from Aisha radiallahu anha, from others. One of them is Ibn Abisin, not Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abisin al-Juhani radiallahu anhu arda, he said that the Prophet ﷺ said to him, Ya Ibn Abisin, ala adulluka, aw ala ukhbiruka bi afdali ma yata'awwadhu bihi al-muta'awwidhun. Oh, Ibn Abis, should I not tell you of the best of ways or the best of things to be done for a person who seeks protection, to use it in finding protection? And then I said, yes, O Messenger of Allah. He said, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ هَاتَانْ السُّورَتَانْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَسَلِّمْ. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi says that this hadith is Hasan Sahih. And, you know, the recitation of these surahs, they cover the best of protections because they cover both the material world and the immaterial world. And you will see that the first chapter, قُلْ عَذْرُ الْفَلَقْ, speaks about the daybreak, speaks about the darkness, speaks about the day and the night. And you find that the second chapter speaks about that which is hidden from us, that which whispers within us, that which is a negative influence in our life. We see this beautiful hadith of Aisha, رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا وَأَرْضَاهَا. She tells us, as is collected by Imam Malik, but collected also by Imam al-Bukhari and others, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to Aisha radiallahu anha to recite these verses. And Aisha, she says, Aisha reports to us, before sleeping, whenever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, before he would fall asleep, he would recite these two surahs, قُلْ عَذُ رَبِّ فَلَقْ قُلْ عَذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, and he would recite the last three chapters of the Qur'an, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ قُلْ عَذُ رَبِّ فَلَقْ قُلْ عَذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ وَيَنْفُثْ, and he would breathe and blow into his hands, وَيَمْسَحْ, and he would wipe all with his hands all over his body. In one narration, all over his body that was exposed. So if he was, you know, his shirt was covered, he would just wipe the parts that were uncovered. If he had, you know, something on his neck and his head, and he would breathe on his hands and wipe it over himself, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this is a direct transmission from Aisha radiallahu anha, who witnessed this from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, one of the great narrators and companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the jinn and from the evil eye in his own dua. So the Prophet would make, you know, ruqya, and he would say, oh Allah, protect me from the jinn, protect me from the evil eye, and so on, for himself, for his grandchildren, from his family. Until these verses were revealed, until these two chapters were revealed, these two chapters were revealed to the Prophet ﷺ, Surah Al-Falaq, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ, Al-Mu'awwidhatayn, were revealed to him ﷺ, and from that moment on, that is what the Prophet ﷺ would recite. Now that's compelling evidence from Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu arda, and he mentions, this statement from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and this action of his. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended it to the best of companions, to his wife, recommended it to the young and to those who is endeared, to those who would give place to ride in his place. He recommended it with a moving, you know, eloquence of introduction about how important it is, how it was revealed to him on that night, how important these two surahs are. And he built up the virtue of these two surahs. And therefore, it becomes very important for you and I to make and implement that practice. So two things that I'm going to leave you with today. When you wake up in the morning, recite the three qul. Qul huwa Allahu ahad, qul a'udhu birabbil falaq, qul a'udhu birabbin nas, three times each. And number two, before you sleep, recite the three qul and recite them three times each into your hand and breathe on them and wipe all parts of your body, in particular those that are exposed and have not been covered. The beginning of the chapter is really quite significant. Surah Al-Falaq, you find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that Allah has asked him to make this dua. Qul, you say to them, teach them, O Muhammad, and ask me by making this dua. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. I seek refuge with the Lord of al-Falaq. And Allah says, Allah al-Faliq al-Habbi wa al-Nawa, Allah is the one who has cloven and, you know, the breaking of the seeds. Now, the word falaq means daybreak. It's where something spreads open and it's something that breaks apart and where something comes into the night nightfall. And from the evil that has been created in it and from the evil that exists in it, min sharri ma khalaq, of what he has created and allowed to be in that night. The Prophet would say to Aisha radiallahu anha, ta'awwadhi min al-falaq, ask Allah to protect you at that time where the nighttime is setting. Al-ghasaq is where night is setting and the sun is setting and night is becoming darker and darker. And we know from the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ that he would say to the Sahaba to bring your children indoors as Maghrib enters. Before the sun sets, bring your children indoors, lock your doors, close your windows, and recite these chapters of the Qur'an, and ask Allah to protect us from the shaitan. So these are all authentic narrations and sunan of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. You find other narrations from many of the Sahaba that speak about the virtues of these two surahs. But what I've mentioned are the core important understandings. Next time we meet, inshallah, tomorrow, I will discuss with you the beginning of Surah Al-Falaq and the concept of a ta'awud. What does it mean to ask Allah for refuge and protection? What does it mean to say a'udhu? A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, and so on and so forth. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us greater insight into the Quran and make us from those who are lovers of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and proving it with faithfulness and action and worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قولوا قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه الغفور الرحيم صلى اللهم وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.